electric engine. And their main power, the power of their far more numerous air force, was thrown into the battle, or else concentrated upon Dunkirk and the beach. Pressing in upon the narrow exit, both from the east and from the west, the enemy began to fire with cannon upon the beaches by which alone the shipping could approach on depart. They sowed magnetic mines in the channels and seas. They sent repeated waves of hostile aircraft, sometimes more than 100 strong in one formation, to cast their bombs from the single pier that remained, and upon the sand dunes, on which the troops had their only shelter. It was in conditions such as these that our men carried on with little or no rest, for days and nights on end, making trip after trip across the dangerous water, bringing with them, always, men from their rescue. There never has been, I suppose, in all the world, in all the history of war, such an opportunity for you. The Knights of the Round Table, the Crusaders, all fall back into the past. Not only distant, but prosaic. These young men going forth every morn to guard their native land and all that we stand for, holding in their hands these instruments of colossal and shattering power, of whom it may be said that every morn brought forth a noble chance, and every chance brought forth a noble knight, deserve my gratitude, and to all the brave men, in so many ways and on so many occasions, are ready and continue ready to give life and all their native land. To the end. We shall fight in France. We shall fight on the seas and oceans. We shall fight with growing confidence and growing strength in the air. We shall fight on the beaches. We shall fight on the landing grounds. We shall fight in the fields and in the streets.